Right. Well, similarly, since this is Exopolitics TV, you have a whole part of the book, part five, that's entitled Aliens, Angels, and UFOs. And I wonder if you could talk us through how you fit all of that in to the grand scheme of the spirit realm.
For sure. Again, like I said, if you are studying angelology, who angels are, what their roles are, things like that, you're eventually going to be led to Enoch, and you're eventually going to be led to aliens. I really feel that this is something that needs to be translated, because in Christendom, the guys you're going to be led to are the Christian ideas that the aliens are evil. That there's evil aliens, that there's nothing good out there. We're not even talking about some good, some bad, some neutral. They're all demonic. The Christian belief is that all aliens are demons, literally, who have come down and they're abducting people and those kind of things like that. So I felt the need to address that within the book. So from my research, I've seen how the word for heavens is the same word for sky in the Greek and the Hebrew. And so we're seeing all of these times within the scriptures how the prophets would gaze into the heavens or look up at the sky, and they would see these different things going on, right? They would see lights in the sky, clouds by day, fire by night, how God would travel and lead the children of Israel through the desert. It sounds awful like a UFO. They look like spheres of fire at night, certain ones. And clouds by day, whether they're cloud ships or they hide in the clouds or they're just kind of blurry, a little bit far away, out of sight. There's definitely a connection there. But looking at the word cloud, and when it comes to demons or the fallen angels, who there's I think the fear agenda is really popular right now. So moving that aside, the demons or angels who were abducting people, and you know, and coming down to the earth, they were kicked out of heaven. Heaven is the sky. Heaven is the abode where the stars are above our head, breaking it down to the scriptures. And they were kicked out of there. So people believe that there's demons flying around in spacecraft abducting people. I don't think that that's accurate. I don't think that they're demonic entities. There's other people who believe that the angels travel back and forth from heaven to earth, carrying messages, appearing to men. Enoch says that as they travel the heavens, they look like a flame of fire. But as they come to earth, they're able to take upon the appearance of men. So they're able to travel back and fire, back and forth through the fire or as a fire. The book of Psalms says that the Lord maketh his ministers as a flame of fire. So they're literally made out of the fire of God. The Bible says that, yes, our God is a consuming fire, like is light. So they're beings that are made out of light, and they travel by the speed of light. A lot of this comes out of just doing my own research from the Christian perspective, which led me again to the fact that, look, all of these encounters and all of these experiences and testimonies that people are coming with, they're demonic. And it's hands down across the board. I'm one of the only ones who have kind of stepped into the Christian realm to say, and I think that these entities could be angelic and could have our greater good in mind if we'll just pay attention. So I really felt the need there. And doing all the research, I was led again to your show, Alfred, and led to people that you've interviewed over the years, especially hats off to James Gilliland and his work at East Eddy Ranch, and looking into that, and even going back to the scriptures with his encounters. And they're going out and they're having these encounters under the stars with these lights coming down and stopping on a dime and almost communicating with the people. And so I began to go out and have my own encounters as well. There was a video that was pretty popular, maybe 2004, 2005, a little bit after that, by a guy named Prophet Yahweh. I'm not sure if you're familiar with Prophet Yahweh, but he went out with ABC News, I believe it was, in California, and he told them that he had the power and the ability to summon UFOs by using the Hebrew version of the Bible. And so as I'm researching all of this, these angels and these demons, all this stuff, I was led to watch that video. And this guy went out and they had a news crew with him, and he raised his hands in the air. He closed his eyes and he said, "Yahweh, if it be your will you let one of your messengers show up to show these people, first of all, that I'm not crazy, and show these people that the angels are out there traveling back and forth." And so I seen the video, that all of a sudden this sphere appears just out of, and it almost seemed like it was just out of the atmosphere, but it was a sphere during the day. And they seen it, and all the people with the news crew, the camera guys, the reporter, they were all blown away. And they said that they called the Air Force Base, and they called the airport, and there was supposed to be nothing in the air, no blimps, no testing, nothing like that. So that video, I said, well, if he's doing it, and I was led to some other people's work. And at the time, Patrick Cook, I quoted him at the beginning of the book. Patrick Cook had a website called BibleUFO.com. which is not up right now. I'm trying to restore that website because there's a vast, vast knowledge that was lost when his website went down after he passed. But his website really related the UFO phenomena and ufology back to the scriptures, and then ancient paintings and drawings. And I mean, he had eyewitness accounts dating back to like the 1500s and even before that, of all of these articles and things that were in the news at the time, and of blimps and these phantoms that would come over Jerusalem, and these things that would come down and mess with people. And it's like, wow, there's a lot more here than meets the eye. So I'm trying my best to restore that website. But it shows you that there's more here than meets the eye, especially going back to the Bible, of seeing how these the cloud by day, the fire by night. There was a beautiful encounter, especially when we went out and had our own experiences with these entities appearing. I mean, I've seen them come out of stars, go into stars. I've seen them fly across the night sky and tag what looked like to be a star. They'll tag it, and then they will change directions, change places with that. And all of that is coming through a place with God of prayer and saying, "Father, would you allow me to see the seraphim?" The word seraphim in the Bible means the fiery ones, those who are made out of fire. They're angelic messengers who carry the fire of God, but they carry messages. And there's so many different types of entities and things that I've seen for myself that I had to write about it. I couldn't do a book on the spirit realm and not include this. And again, drawing the conclusions and painting it back to the Bible. There was a story of Elijah and the young man. Elijah and the young man were on the run, and there was an invading army that was chasing them. They went to sleep, woke up the next morning, and there was a huge army surrounding Elijah and this young man. The young man begins to panic. "We're done. It's over. we're finished." And Elijah says, "Wait, not so fast." He says, "Because there are more who are for us than those who are against us." And he's like, "What are you talking about? It's two of us versus, you know, 1,000 chariots and people out here ready to kill us." And so he lays his hands on the young man, and he prays for him. And he says, "Father, if it be your will, would you open his eyes and allow him to see those who are for us?" And God opens the eyes of this young man. He looks around in the mountains all around them. And it says there appeared chariots as of fire all around them in the mountains. And he was able to see the angelic armies that were watching over him. He was able to see the fleets of what we may call UFOs, or these chariots of fire. Breaking down the word chariot, it goes back to the word, it just simply means vehicle in the scripture. So it doesn't mean a horse-drawn chariot or a buggy. Chariot means vehicle. And it's also in the Hebrew where we get the word Merkaba or Merkaba, which means a vehicle of light. In Eastern mysticism, it's believed that through meditation, one can turn their body into a Merkaba through the different breathing techniques and different levels of ascension that you can do, of achieving rainbow body, turning your body into light, into a vehicle of light, and traveling the universe by turning your body into a Merkaba. So when we talk about these things, they're not so foreign after all. That we see them with a lot of it's lost in translation, and then a lot of it is lost in people wanting to own an idea of evil aliens, of, you know, just outside invading force that's against us. So it all ties back into the scriptures, and I think that there are these entities out there who are watching over us, who have our greater good in mind. But there are entities here who wish to deceive, but they're here. I don't think that they're out there. I explore these concepts and more in my new book, Spirit Realm: Angels, Demons, Spirits, and the Sovereignty of God. Forward by Jordan Maxwell. Available now at truthseeker.com.